the good people at Hear360 have come up with the Ecoplate.
The Ecoplate was designed in the 1980s by Jim Cunningham, who worked for Programming Technologies. Programming Technologies created something that could be considered similar to the EMT. However, everybody that used it loved it because it had a lot flatter frequency response. It was brighter without being too bright. I've been told that Bruce Sweetian loved the Ecoplate, and he insisted when he worked in studios that they have an Ecoplate, which might explain why a couple of studios I've worked at have them.
The Ecoplate is a plate in one of my favorite studios, Sunset Sound. It is quite a famous plate that has been used on many, many records. You know and love many albums that use this plate, I guarantee it. For me, I'm excited because it is something I've used hundreds of times and know very, very well. Hear360 have spent a lot of time and energy, and they've let us be involved. And now for something completely different, my Python moment there, we are actually going to have two other wonderful YouTubers in here, Adam Steele from Hot Pole Studios and Paul Third. Paul Third, as I'm sure you're aware if you watch any plugin reviews, really gets under the hood in plugins, and he puts them through their paces. And Paul, like myself and Adam, got to play around with this plugin in depth. And Paul gave them intense notes, and they listened, and they refined things. It means a lot that they listened to all three of us and have done something really remarkably good. I'm going to take you through it. I'm going to thank Hear360 in advance for giving away three copies of this. Don't forget, you can enter to win one of the three copies. You can also get it at a special introductory price of $99. And of course, you can try out the free trial. And we always, you know, recommend, if you're not sure, try it out on the free trial and see if you like it. Here we go. So here it is. Here's the Ecoplate. So immediately at 0.75 of a second, it's a lot more natural sounding than the Avid one I was using. You're not all surprised by that, obviously, but still. I'm not afraid to like slam it on the output, but I like the fact it's defaulted to 100% wet because 99.9% of the time, I'm going to use my reverb at 100%. And I'd rather it defaulted to that than 50-50 like some plugins do, and then I have to remember to turn it all the way to 100%. That might sound petty, but actually it's quite annoying. So there's an analogue setting here, see what it does. I'm not entirely sure what the analog setting does. I think Paul Third will probably talk about that in his review. Right, there's a high pass post. Interesting. Oh, I can make it pre and low pass pre. I like it set on pre. Nice. Oh, it's quite dramatic. Obviously, what I can say about this is it's very clean. Very, very clean. 3 delay. So you can sync it to tempo. If you don't sync it to tempo, I see it's continuously variable. If you sync it to tempo, it goes in. That's really smart. We've got 32nd, 16th, 8th, triplet. Great. Without. All right, so it's a really good snare reverb. Excellent. Let's go and try it on a vocal. What I love about this vocal was live. Can you tell the amount of bleed going on? I think it was also handheld.
Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the
So much bleed going on. Okay, we love it. All right, let's create a stereo auxiliary. I am going to brighten this vocal and get rid of some of the low lows. It was very compressed going in. He was screaming into the mic.
Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth, hate me, I'll be yours till I die, crazy, pull me in, drag me down, make me cry for you, lie for you, break me, I'll be yours. Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth, hate me, I'll be yours till I die.
I've got to be honest, this is so clean. You know what I mean? There's no like crappy artifacts or whatever, it is clean.
Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth, hate me, I'll be yours till I die.
Bring it in.
Till I die crazy.
There's a reason why people like the original Ecoplate. And I think it is, it's that cleanness. It's, I mean, just listen again.
Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth, hate me, I'll be yours till I die crazy, pull me in, drag me down.
It sounds expensive, doesn't it? It sounds really, I'm going to use this word. I hate this word, but I'm going to use it. Professional. It does. It just sounds like a reverb that is going to work for me every time. I'm always a little afraid of stepping out too far with different verbs. The cleanliness of this is pretty fantastic.
Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth.
I mean, it's dumb. It works perfectly for me. I love this rotary control here. Look, I can grab it here and move it. So you can move it manually, or you could better. You can move it manually, or you can control it from here, which is great in half second steps. Input and output makes perfect sense. Got a low pass and a high pass. I've high passed it on the vocal there. I've turned on the analogue emulation. I don't know what that's actually doing. It's probably adding a little bit of extra noise and stuff. Isn't that what analogue does? You know, I can sync it to the tempo, meaning the pre-delay here can be set to actually be in time with the song. And then, of course, I've got a mix control here where you can move from 0 to 100% if you want to put it directly on it. I can set the VU meter to either read input or output, like this. The moment it's set on out. Pretty fantastic. So it's a really good, clean sounding reverb that doesn't have a lot of artifacts and nonsense that gets in the way that messes up your mix. You can see why traditionally we love the original ones. Here 360 have spent a lot of time making this right. And they listened to ideas that we had. And Paul in particular gave them loads of great notes that they listened to and like really made this fantastic. I love the idea that plugin manufacturers will listen to end users and create something really remarkably good. It's clean. It sounds great. I'm very impressed. So I've got these two very ugly guitar sounds here. Now, many of you will know I love this trick of sending one guitar one side, the other guitar the other side, but then it's reverb opposite. It helps keep things wide. So let's try that. So I'm going for the split mono. So what this means is I can send to one side of the echo plate from one guitar and the other side from the other guitar. So if I make this input here 15, 16, and then I take the left-hand pan guitar and pan to 16, it will appear on the opposite side. And I'll take the other guitar, the right-hand guitar, and pan that to, you guessed it, send that to 15. So let's have a listen. High pass and low pass. So if you see here, I'm playing the left-hand guitar. And I'm getting all the reverb on the right. And then vice versa. Right hand guitar, reverb all on the left. Shorten the reverb. Mute it. So much more interesting with it on. Off. Turn it on. Shut me up, steal the truth, hate me, I'll be yours till I die. So I'm loving just how simple this is to use. Very, very straightforward. But most importantly, I think the thing that probably will resonate with all of you is the fact that it's super clean and super functional and isn't going to mess up your mix with tons of weird artifacts, and it's really nice. Back to the vocal. Steal the truth, hate me, I'll be yours till I die, till I die, till I die crazy. Pull me in, drag me down, make me cry for you, lie for you, break me. I mean, it sounds like the plate. At Sunset Sound, that's because they have an echo plate. Really fantastic. Let's go over some of the advanced features. If we click these three lines here, we actually get the controls for the analogue that I was turning on and off. So at the moment, you can see the saturation and noise was pretty low. If I go to our vocal verb, turn it on, it's already set on analogue there. It's hit it a little harder. Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth, hate me, I'll be yours. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my bus send here and I'm going to go pre-fade and then mute the lead vocal. So all we're going to listen to now is the reverb itself. You can hear the saturation. Pretty clean.
Till I
Pretty nice. Let's crank the noise. I'm going to turn the saturation down, turn the noise up. Noise is one of those things where it's probably adding some sort of randomization, which might be nice. The saturation I'm hearing and enjoying, the noise is something I may not ever adjust. It's a nice feature to have some saturation on it. Now, this is an interesting one here. We can increase the width. So let's see how that works. Wow. This could be really interesting for string pads, for anything that feels quite mono that you're trying to get out of the center. Tone control, low, mid-low, mid and high. Oh, nice. Actually, I like cutting the low. Although obviously we can do that with a high pass and there's probably not much happening because it's already being high passed. So I think regardless of this. Yeah, it's barely doing anything. That's because the high pass is engaged here. I think full up, it may have done something ever so slight. Let's hear the low mids. Yeah, you can hear that. But definitely the mid range is quite interesting. I'll turn the highs off. Bring slowly. Mid's quite nice. Just to hear that with the vocal. Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth, hate me. At the moment, you'll notice I've got the Ecoplate on its own auxiliary. So if I wanted to send from multiple inputs to it, I could do that. Now, many people, and in many instances, people mix directly on the channel. So what is nice of Ecoplate, they've come up with this new, pretty, maybe other people do it, but I haven't noticed it yet. But this, so if I take the Ecoplate, let's open it up directly on the channel. Now, I usually pathologically hate doing that because, well, number one, it affects the volume. So if I do this. Let's go for like a 2 second reverb. Hate me, I'll be yours till I die, till I die, till I die crazy. Pull me in, drag me down, make me cry for you, laugh for you, break me. I'll be yours till I die, till I die, till I die crazy. So, what you're hearing when I turn that up and down is volume changes, because what's happening is, like, and this happens with all reverbs, all delays and everything. If I go to 100% mix, it gets quieter. Listen to it in the mix. So that's a problem, isn't it? So basically what's happening is you've got 100% reverb on it and the volume decreases dramatically. It's all the reverb. Guys at Ecoplate at Here 360 have done this. So if I hit this and change it to level, LVL, listen now. Numb me up, dumb me down, baby, shut me up, steal the truth, hate me. I'll be yours till I die, till I die, till I die crazy. Really smart, really simple, absolutely love it. So what they're doing there is they're keeping the vocal at the same level the whole time, regardless of how you set the mix. Good, great idea. Not even a good idea, a great, great idea. So why don't we go over and hang out with Mr. Paul Third? Paul is going to give us his opinion based on CPU usage, how it runs, and all of the other technical details that Paul is really good at doing. Over to you, Paul.
Hello, everyone. My name is Paul Third, and I am here to look under the hood of the new Ecoplate plugin. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a look in a plugin doctor, and we're going to have a look and see from a technical aspect how the plugin works, if the plugin is working correctly, if all the functions work. So we'll look at the functions, we'll look at the saturation, aliasing via some physical sweeps as well, and we'll also look at the CPU consumption as well of the Ecoplate plugin. So let's get into it. So first off, let's have a look at the filters. So first off, you've got a low pass filter and you've got a high pass filter as well. So as you can see, the filters work as you would expect a low pass and a high pass filter to work. High pass filter rolls off the lows, low pass filter rolls off the highs. Works exactly as you would imagine. Then from there, you've got the analog section where you've got drive, noise, and you've also got EQ as well. So you've got low, low mids, mid and highs. So really easy. All I'm going to do is start making some cuts and some boosts in the lows, low mids, mids and highs. As you can see, all the bands work as intended. The low band works perfectly fine. You can cut, you can boost. Low mids works absolutely fine. Cut, you can boost. Mid band, you guessed it, you can cut, you can boost. High band, you can cut and you can boost. Works absolutely perfect, and it's actually a very good addition as well. Not many reverb plugins come with additional EQ tonal options as well. It's quite a handy little tool. Now, the big bit, okay? The big bit of the analog section, in my opinion, comes in the forms of the saturation and the noise. So what we'll do is we'll move into the harmonic section of Plugin Doctor so I can show you the harmonics of the saturator. So as you can see there, you're getting quite a good amount of harmonic content in there. Quite a lot of harmonic content in there for a reverb plugin, which to me is quite cool because, again, you do not get drive and saturation functions in every reverb. But actually, it's quite a nice effect as well. So this is the modeled THD of the unit itself. Now, all you guys will be asking saturation. If you know my channel, you will be expecting this. Aliasing, right? When it comes to analog saturation, or it just comes into saturation at all, aliasing is something that's normally always inevitable. I am extremely happy to tell you that there is no aliasing in this plugin whatsoever in terms of its saturation. As you can see in Plugin Doctor, there is no aliasing, and that is at 48 kilohertz as well. And just to prove it, what I've done is I've printed physical sweeps through Pro Tools and then imported them into Isotope RX7. And as you can see, right, so what I'm going to show you now is the reverb without the saturation enabled. Okay, this is actually with the analog mode off. This is with the saturation enabled at full drive, right? Absolute full saturation. So as you can see, there is harmonic content, but there is no aliasing whatsoever. So as you can see, there's no aliasing in Plugin Doctor, and there's also no aliasing in the physical plugin as well in the DAW. And in terms of the noise, you can choose to add the modeled noise of the unit up and down as well. I don't know why you would want to, I don't know why you would want to do that. Normally when it comes to noise, I have it switched off completely. I don't want to add any noise. But if you are a bit of an analog freak and you want to stay true to the hardware, you can increase the noise as well. And again, the results that we've seen on Plugin Doctor are consistent with what we actually get within the DAW as well. As you can see, that is without the analog, that is with the noise on. So it is adding in a ton of noise. The function works as it should. Plugin Doctor and the DAW are getting the exact same results. And lastly, in terms of the functions, you have a mix knob, which again works as intended. If you have the mix to zero, you will get a completely linear, dry result as expected. The last thing you'll be wondering is CPU usage. Now, in terms of the CPU usage, I've got quite a powerful computer. I'm running an i9 computer, okay? Now, in terms of short reverb times, you're looking maybe about, say, 4 to 6%. In terms of the analog switch, the analog mode doesn't really add much. You'll actually find it stays roughly the same in terms of CPU. Now, the guys at Hear360 did tell me that there is some form of convolution in this reverb plugin. For anybody who doesn't know, convolution is all about sampling in IRs. So I don't know for sure, but I'm pretty sure there has been some form of sampling in terms of the real gear. Okay, so you should expect a little bit more CPU than algorithmic plugins. I don't know if it's full convolution, I just know that there's some convolution in there, all right? So 4 to 6% seems okay. However, However, if you start to move up in your reverb time, the CPU will increase and it doubles. If you say like have your reverb time kind of halfway, you're looking maybe between like 10 to 12%. If you kind of hit it maybe like up to the 6 second mark and or really like max out your reverb time, you're looking as much as 20 odd percent CPU. Pro Tools, we know Pro Tools isn't the greatest, but 20% on an i9 is quite a lot. And it kind of gets a little bit worse as well. But again, I'll explain why that is. So if you are using a high reverb time and you start to dial in the saturation, you're going to notice quite another bump in CPU. You're kind of going to be looking in between maybe 35 to sometimes like 40% CPU. That is a lot. Now, the reason that is due to the anti-aliasing. When it comes to saturation on plugins and plugins that make high order harmonics, there's going to be some form of aliasing. Normally, a way of combating that is anti-aliasing filters, or you can internally oversample. I'm not entirely sure exactly what they've done. There might be some internal oversampling going on there, I'd imagine, and that's why you're possibly getting quite a big CPU hit. So for me to kind of sum up from like an audio geek point of view, all the functions work. I had no issues in the DAW. I tried it in Cubase and Pro Tools. There was no issues. All the functions work. There's no aliasing. You can add all the nice non-linearities of the hardware. Yes, you're going to get a bit of a CPU bump, but I'd imagine, especially as it's got a little bit of convolution in there as well, that this is going to sound pretty close to the hardware. I would like to think so. I won't know that because I've not got an Ecoplate. But one guy that does have a very good ear is going to show you how this thing sounds is the man himself, Warren Hewitt. So Warren, thank you very much for including me in this week's plugin review. And hopefully you might see me again sometime to deliver you some more audio geekness and dive more into Plugin Doctor. So my name is Paul Third. Thank you very much, Warren, for including me on the channel. And hopefully I'll see you again sometime soon.
I hope you enjoyed Paul's breakdown. Now we're going to go to our very, very good friend, Mr. Adam Steele. Adam Steele has a YouTube channel called Hop Pole Studios. And like I was saying earlier, he's a Reaper power user. Whatever that means, I just made that up. The point is he's really, really good at Reaper and lives, eats, and breathes it. And he's going to run this inside of Reaper.
Hello, everybody. Adam Steele here. And I'm checking out Ecoplate in Reaper. I am pleased to tell you that it works perfectly well. And I have a track here by a band called Banana Ranch, which is called Weather, and it's a lovely song. And so I pulled up a preset called Big, Fat, and Wide. Let's check it out. Sounds really nice. Let's hear it soloed with the vocal and just the plate.
I've been trying to get a grip of myself.
You can hear there's really quite a long, nice, lush release on that. It's a nice, and it's got a high pass here that's been engaged to take some of the super lows out. It's been taken down to 10k-ish on a low pass. And there's the analogue switch, which if I open up the settings here, it's got the analogue mode on with some saturation and extra width. And of course, boost in the mid lows, low mids I would call it, and a bit of a duck on the mids and the highs. So it gives us, if I take off the original,
to get a grip of my thoughts.
I'm really liking that, but I might take the low mids down and I'm going to shorten the reverb off to, let's try 3 seconds.
To get a grip of myself. Oh, times are changing and I'm losing track of my thoughts.
More saturation.
On days like this, you're all that I have got, and I'm grateful.
Yeah, this is a really nice plate. It sounds a lot like the old EMT 250 or even the 140. And it's just got that thing about it where it's not nasty in the mix. Let's try that again, and let's add a bit onto all the guitars as well. Nice little Reaper trick there. I just dragged from the send section on the guitar group over to the vocal plate, just drag and drop. And suddenly that had a send going over there. Post effects, post fader, full up, nice shortcut. And then all I had to do was take it down to taste. And now I can shift and click on that to bypass it or not. So we can hear it without and with. I'm starting to lose the drums a little in the mix balance there, but that's fine. If I was doing this as a full mix, I would go back and rebalance everything. But I'm really liking the sound of this echo plate. I can narrow the stereo width all the way through to mono. I can add noise if I want, but I don't want. That's not a me thing. Some guys like that. I can EQ it inside here so I don't have to throw an extra plugin on. And of course, the high and low pass are really useful on delays and reverbs. The pre-delay can be useful too, which means that if I so choose... But yeah, I can add loads of pre-delay. Not that I would usually want more than about 200 milliseconds of pre-delay, but if you're going for that big thing like London Grammar or that kind of big sound, you can really low-pass it to make it quite thick-sounding, make it quite long, and pre-delay it quite a lot as well, and that will add that extra size. If I... just add, let's say, 300-400 milliseconds and just listen to the vocals and the plate here.
To get a grip of myself.
It's too much.
Oh, times are changing and I'm losing track of my thoughts. On days like this, you're all that I have got, and I'm grateful.
And that pre-delay there is giving us a distinct gap in between the words and that big plate lushness, which brings some detail back. Really useful. Back to you.
So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you ever so much, Here360, for letting us try this out, for letting us give away 3 copies, and most importantly, listening to us and really creating something really quite wonderful. I like this plugin a lot. A lot of the plugins we review, I end up using sporadically here and there. Couple become full-time. I think something that sounds this good and is this simple could be pretty darn full-time for me. And to be honest, because I'm a Sunset Sound fan and devotee, as they say, because this is an incredibly accurate reproduction of the plate they have over there, which I know and love and have used hundreds of times, I think I love this. I think this will make it into a lot more of the mixes, so you can watch the mixes and find out for yourself. All right, don't forget, you can win one of 3 copies of Ecoplate. You can also, if you want, download the free trial, and they have an introductory price of $99. So don't forget that you can go, you can buy it, you can enter to win, or you can try out the free trial. All of those options are down below. Thank you ever so much for watching. Have a marvelous time recording and mixing. So long, farewell, au revoir, adios, goodbye, tschüss.